So this object thing is quite interesting. Now, we were saying last time that we think of this deck of cards or these trains or stations as being the units which do the calculations, computations. So we ask a procedure, actually it's done inside an object.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, hidden inside the object.
So that's, but these objects,
where do they come from?
Yeah, I mean, who makes the objects? How do you start an object? How do you know that you have a deck of cards?
But we saw it, the train thing, the train got created by somebody, right?
Correct. The train thing we had, like we said, that the train card is like a template, a class of trains, and we said make a train.
We told the class.
Yeah, we told the class make a train starting on a Monday, another train starting on a Tuesday,
right,
following this thing. But then, for instance, in the scorecards, we didn't have this, right?
So even station also. Station, where did it come from?
Yeah, station was also permanently there. So we need some.
We have to create it, maybe.
Yeah. So who's we?
We as in the
some person. The environment, whoever is executing this whole, setting up this whole thing. So we are kind of
some objects have to be created.
Okay. So we are kind of organizing our computation.
But you know, I mean, one thing is that they ask objects, right? But one thing is that, you know, I mean, you need only create one object. If I create one object, that object can create other. Like we saw, we create a station, the station created trains or something.
Yeah.
So you can create one object.
Okay. So let's see. For example, we had this idea that the scorecard could be one single unit, or it could be different people reporting marks in different subjects. So we said there may be
physics teachers,
maths teachers.
Maths teacher, yeah.
And then there is a class teacher who kind of coordinates these subject teachers.
Right. So there are four objects.
So we could create a class teacher, you're saying. And then leave it to the class teacher to create the other subject teachers.
Is there a difference? I mean, if the class teacher, if I say I create a class teacher object, the class teacher object then in turn creates
physics, maths
and chemistry teachers objects. Versus, I create all the four objects myself.
Well, what? I suppose if the class teacher has created these subject teachers, unless the class teacher tells us who they are, we don't know who they are, right? So in a way, we don't directly have a way of talking,
asking them to do
things.
So if I make a class teacher and the class teacher creates these three objects, physics, chemistry, and maths, then I can't talk to the physics.
Yeah, unless the class teacher allows me to.
Unless the class teacher passes that object to me.
They have to give me a way of contacting the, right?
Otherwise, I can't see them.
Yeah. So, it's like, you know, supposing you're, you're answering some inquiries and then to answer, so supposing you're running an institute and somebody calls saying, tell me something about whatever, how to do this. So, you might ask somebody and then report back, but you don't give that person directly.
You don't give the professor's number to.
Yeah, exactly. Right?
Okay.
Yeah. So, same way, the class teacher may or may not let us talk.
Not give us the phone number of the
chemistry. So, if you want the physics marks, you come through me.
You come through. I have to ask only the class teacher. That's interesting. So, okay. So, if I make all the four objects.
Yeah. Then you can directly.
I can talk to physics teacher directly.
Yeah.
But that's a little chaotic because if I ask the physics teacher something, will tell me, and I ask the class teacher will ask the physics teacher.
Yes.
And then class teacher will tell me something, and then I can compare that.
Exactly. And then you might also be doing things. So the class teacher may, so for instance, if we are computing some grades or something, the class teacher might have a rule to make grades.
And
we might create our own mechanism to make grades. And then if we ask the class teacher for grades, we'll get a different
grade.
If we get the three marks individually and compute the grade, we might give it.
Then we will, then we'll have problems. So it's better that in some sense, for some problems at least, in this case at least, it's better that we allow only the class teacher to do all these things.
So we basically need to know only a certain, I mean, we don't need to know all the details.
Better not to know the details.
Yeah. So, for instance, we don't even need to know that there are three teachers. Maybe the class teacher is actually keeping track of all the marks directly. Who knows? Maybe a class teacher has a record. Maybe class teacher is the physics teacher.
correct. Actually, that's true.
That could be.
Many times.
Yeah.
So, and they may change also.
Yeah.
You know, physics teacher today may be somebody, but they may go and leave. Somebody else may come as physics teacher.
Yeah.
If I have an old physics teacher, I'll call that physics teacher, old teacher. No, I'm not the...
Correct. Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Now
this relieves us of knowing all these details.
Knowing all these details.
Yeah.
So so that's nice. That is an interesting difference.
Yeah. Yeah. So we basically have this indirect thing. Yeah.
So if you draw it diagrammatically, it means that actually you have one object. Are the other three objects inside this first object or may or may not be? Yeah?
Well,
but
in this
you can't
case,
see them.
Yeah. I mean, they are kind of connected here. So we could say that they are inside. But they need not always be inside. They could be outside. Mm-hmm. So here we have our class teacher with whom we can have a conversation. We can ask certain procedures to be executed.
Okay.
And this class teacher has created this physics, maths and chemistry teachers. Right. So they are sitting behind me.
Or inside.
Or inside. And then each of these teachers can now talk to the class teacher.
Okay.
And so the class teacher can collect marks and add them up, give us a total, give us the average, all these kinds of things by querying the inside teachers. But we don't have
access to
access to these teachers directly.
So that's a significant difference. Okay. Mm. All right.